Hey guys, welcome back to Genealogy and Chronology. Today we are diving deep into the genealogical history of the Maurya dynasty, its rise to prominence, the pivotal rulers, the ascent of Ashoka the Great, and ultimately the downfall of this remarkable empire. So let's embark on this historical odyssey. This chart is part 11 of the 12-part series on the history of the Telangana project by Genealogy and Chronology. Please consider subscribing to my channel if you are interested in learning about the history of Indian royal houses. The Maurya dynasty was an ancient Indian dynasty that thrived from the 4th to the 2nd century BCE. Founded by Chandragupta Maurya, the dynasty marked a significant period in Indian history. Chandragupta Maurya, under the guidance of his advisor Chanakya, established the dynasty by defeating the Nanda Empire and consolidated power across northern India. The capital of the empire was Pataliputra, which is present-day Patna in Bihar. After ruling for over 25 years, Chandragupta Maurya abdicated the throne in favor of his son and embraced the life of a Jain ascetic under the guidance of the revered Jain teacher Bhadrabahu. Chandragupta was succeeded by his son Bindusara, who was also known as Amitragata, meaning the slayer of foes. Bindusara continued to expand the empire's territory through conquest and diplomacy. His reign saw the incorporation of many regions into the Mauryan Empire, making it one of the largest empires in ancient India. Like his father, Bindusara also enjoyed a long reign of close to 25 years. Bindusara was supposed to be succeeded by his son Susima, who was crown prince of the empire. After the death of Bindusara, there was a period of succession struggle among his sons. Ashoka and Susima were just two of several sons vying for the throne. Ashoka, who was serving as the governor of Ujjain under his father, marched to Pataliputra and seized the throne. Ashoka had all his brothers killed, including crown prince Susima, after he assumed the throne, and only his full brother, Vitashoka, was left alive. Ashoka, also known as Ashoka the Great, is one of the most celebrated and significant rulers in Indian history. He reigned from approximately 268 BCE to 232 BCE. Ashoka's reign is known for its transformative impact on Indian society and his commitment to Buddhism and the principles of nonviolence and moral righteousness. One of the defining moments of Ashoka's life was the Kalinga War, fought around 261 BCE. The war, which resulted in a brutal and bloody victory for the Mauryan Empire over the Kingdom of Kalinga, deeply affected Ashoka. He was appalled by the suffering and loss of life, leading to a profound moral and spiritual transformation. After the Kalinga War, Ashoka underwent a conversion to Buddhism. His conversion marked a significant departure from the military expansionism of his earlier years. Ashoka became a fervent patron of Buddhism and worked to spread its teachings and principles throughout the Mauryan Empire. He erected rock and pillar edicts across his vast empire, inscribing Buddhist principles and his commitment to the welfare of his subjects. Ashoka had many wives and concubines and fathered many children. He was first married to Devi, a daughter of a merchant from central India. Ashoka was still a prince when he married Devi, and from this marriage were born Mahinda and Sangamitra. Later, these two siblings would go on to propagate and spread Buddhism to Sri Lanka. Ashoka later married Karuvi, and she is the only empress consort whose name appears in inscriptions. Prince Tivala was born from this marriage. Ashoka was married to Padmavati, and from this marriage was born Prince Kunala, and he was the crown prince of the empire. It is likely that Prince Kunala was born before Prince Tivala. Ashoka was also married to Asandhamitra. Even though there were no issues from this marriage, Asandhamitra adopted Charumati, a daughter born to one of the concubines of Ashoka. Charumati was later married to a Nepalese prince, and she propagated Buddhism into Nepal by establishing a monastery. Apart from these marriages, Ashoka was also married to Tishya Raksha. It is also assumed that Ashoka fathered many children from his numerous concubines. Unfortunately, none of Ashoka's sons were destined to become emperors. Mahinda had renounced his rights by becoming a Buddhist monk. Kunala was blinded when he was a crown prince, and Tivala had predeceased his father. The exact date of Ashoka's death is not definitely recorded in historical sources, but it is generally believed to have occurred around 232 BCE. After Ashoka's death, his empire faced a period of succession struggles and instability. The most common accepted account is that his grandson, Dasharatha Maurya, succeeded him as the emperor of the Mauryan Empire. Dasharatha Maurya was the son of Prince Tiwala. Dasharatha Maurya's reign is relatively less documented in historical sources compared to the reigns of Chandragupta, Bindusara, and Ashoka. Historical records about his rule are somewhat limited. Dasharatha was succeeded by his cousin Samprati Maurya. Samprati is believed to have been Ashoka's grandson and the son of Ashoka's son Kunala. Samprati Maurya is primarily remembered for his patronage of Jainism, one of the major religious traditions in ancient India. Under his rule, Jainism flourished, and he is said to have undertaken various initiatives to support the Jain faith. Samprati was the last Mauryan emperor who held somewhat significant authority. Samprati was succeeded by his son Shalishuka Maurya. The Mauryan Empire under Shalishuka and his successors experienced a gradual decline and eventually fragmented into smaller regional entities over time. Shalishuka would be followed by Devavarman, Shatadhanvan, and lastly Briharatha Maurya. Briharatha Maurya was overthrown by his general Pushyamitra Sangha, who went on to establish the Shunga dynasty. The decline of the Maurya Empire marked the end of a significant era in Indian history. It paved the way for the rise of other regional powers and dynasties in various parts of Indian subcontinent like the Greco-Bactrian Empire, Shunga Empire, and the Satavahana Empire. I hope you all like this complete overview of the Maurya dynasty royal house. This concludes all the dynasties that ruled over Telangana region in recorded history. Join me later this month as I discuss the complete timeline of History of Telangana, which is going to be the last part in the History of Telangana series by Genealogy and Chronology. You can watch the videos of the other 10 dynasties that ruled Telangana region after the Mauryas by clicking on the playlist on my channel. Please consider liking the video and subscribing to my channel and sharing this video with your friends and family. If you want to buy a copy of this chart, please visit genealogyandchronology.com. If you like my work, please consider supporting me on Patreon by becoming a member, or you can buy me a coffee by scanning this QR code. Thank you.